Hey, I'm Merle. Welcome back to Prairie Wings. I just got off the phone with a guy and he had questions about an LQ4. And I have to answer these questions all the time. I've had a few LSs apart. I got some experience in these things and I'd like to share my experiences because there is actually, I would call it two, maybe more versions of the LQ4. And I haven't had them all apart and I would like some of the feedback to see what experiences people have actually found. Because the books say one thing, but I've had some experiences that might be a little bit different. So let's go over that. So let's get at it. Okay, I really would like your experience with all of the LQ4 questions or answers that you might have, because this video, let's just clarify a whole bunch of stuff with it. So first of all, LQ4 is a 6-liter truck engine from, I don't know, I think it was 99 to 2007. Now there's debate on that, whether it's 06 or 07, but this is a 2007 block. Anyways, everyone says, do not change the cam bearings. Well, GM had a very poor cam bearing in these engines. The rest of the bearings were beautiful, but GM actually had a bearing that had kind of fingers that went together to put these bearings in. So they're a split bearing, they're a terrible bearing. And the whole story on it is GM put the bearings in, then honed them after, whatever, it doesn't matter. You change the bearings in them. I don't like leaving the cam bearings in. And one reason why is a lot of LQ4s come my way and the middle cam bearing looks like this. This one was chewed up right against the lifter and it has done some damage. It was probably running fine, but pulled out because of noise. Anyway, change of cam bearings. Now, that is where things start to differ. One of the things, cam bearings, they are different size from the early Gen 3 to the late Gen 3. So we have LS engines that started and the first ones were Gen 3, then we went to Gen 4. We're sticking LQ4. That's a Gen 3 motor, but there's two different series. So LQ4 is the same name, everything, but the early ones, now they say that the cam bearing split starts in 04, or do they? Some places say 03, and I have evidence because I have an 03 block in the back that uses the different cam bearings. So first of all, let's just look. Here's where the cam bearing goes in this LS. And this is 07 block, and these bearings are midway 03 or whatever it is, back, or 04 back. And I'd like some clarification what you guys have found. So this bearing is the early one. And if you look, like, I mean, it just flops in here. This bearing isn't gonna work. We're gonna look more at the bearings on the bench and talk a little bit more about that. And I'll probably do a video of changing these cam bearings. So let's take a look at the bench. This is the early cam bearing part number. This is late cam bearing part number. And if you look inside here, you will notice that the late ones are wider. Now, the most common bearing to fail in these LSs is the center one. And the center one in here just happens to measure the same as this. So even if you have a block of the early Gen 3 that's messed up, you can save that block with a wider bearing. These are also, this whole set is actually wider and bigger holes than the original GM Gen 3 late model block. So anyway, this bearing set you can easily put in and get this engine back up and running. So I think I've beat that one up enough. So we got the cam bearings. We know that we have a difference and you're gonna have to measure your bores. The outer bores and the second bore and back and second from the back, they're different size in these sets, but the middle ones, the bearings are interchangeable. There is, I mean, a very slight variation, but they do work. Okay, you gotta forgive me about the mess on the bench. It's my daughter's fault.
Oh, thanks.
No, what it is she's actually ripping a motor apart and cleaning it up. Now, the thing that I would like to address next is the head bolts. So with these head bolts, it seems to be wherever the cam bearing brake is, the head bolt brake is the same. And so we have a set of long head bolts. And then, so this is a two length head bolt set. And then this is a single length head bolt set. And what I'll do is, I don't have the early block unwrapped, the other ones in the back, but we'll go over to the engine and take a look at, if we were to put this head bolt in that engine, how long they'd be. In this block, this one uses the short head bolts. So if I were to take the long head bolt, yeah, it's sticking out a long ways. There's a drastic difference in these head bolts. So the threads in the block, in the later blocks, they're all up at the top, all of them. With the different length ones, well, the threads are way, way buried deep down in the block. So that's one thing that you're gonna have to be very aware of. And these end ones are the shorter ones, because there's no room to go way down into the block to thread these holes. So this is early bolt, late block, would not work. All right, I have a question about pistons that I really don't know the answer to, and I'm hoping someone can answer. These pistons are coated, and I haven't paid attention to when the year break was or when they did or didn't coat. I have a 03 motor apart that is coated, and this I'm assuming is earlier. I'd love to know when the coating started in these LS engines. Now, the other thing, so this is a 2007 piston, and I have 2003 pistons with the coating on. So the other thing is, the rods changed. Now, according to all that I can find, the rods changed for 2005 through 2007. People call them the Gen 4 rods. I don't know, I haven't actually compared them. Most of the time this stuff gets thrown out. But if you look at the rods, this is the early rod, this is the late rod. They are both what you call cracked cap rods. So they actually don't have a machine surface here, they are cracked. So GM manufactures these and then breaks them very scientifically, but you can see that they're just broke off and then they bolt together virtually seamless. Okay, the other thing with this is, and it'd be great if someone could put comments in about the LQ9 motor, because according to what I've heard, and I honestly couldn't tell you, the LQ9s all had floating pins and heavier rods. That'd be interesting, even though this video is about LQ4s. So in this piston, if you look at the wrist pin, when I move this here, this is the wrist pin. The early ones, they are pressed in wrist pins. So this is pressed into here. In the late motors, the wrist pin is not pressed in. They are free floating pins, and there's a ring in there that we have to pull out and clean all this. But this is a floating pin. So if I want to, say, change the pistons in this, this one here, unless you have the proper tools, you would get this done at a machine shop. And this one here, you're gonna be able to pull this retaining ring out and pull this assembly apart. Another thing, if you are wondering whether you have an LQ4 or LQ9, because both blocks have 6 liter stamped on them or cast into them, well, the difference is the LQ9 is higher compression than the LQ4. So the LQ4 has a dished piston and the LQ9 is completely a flat top piston, giving it higher compression, which that's why the LQ9s made higher horsepower. And that's the other thing is, there's a whole whack of debate on different LQ4 cams and LQ9s. Now, most people don't care because they throw all that out, because a camshaft is a massive change in these engines. But let me know what you know about camshafts. I would be very interested to see if people actually have factual information on different camshafts. This isn't actually a LQ4 difference thing, but everyone's wondering about the knock sensors usually when they're talking to me about it and whether they need a relocation kit. Well, that's up to you. But in the Gen 3 motors, they're a 24 tooth crank sensor, and they also have the knock sensors under the intake. And so there's plugs in here, knock sensors live below there, and these end up corroding up and giving you a bunch of code problems and so on with knock sensors. But just for interest's sake, this is what it looks like under the intake, and those are the knock sensors. Well, this LQ4 is mine and I'm really excited about it because my daughter has already got experience working on some other engines of mine, honing and doing stuff like that. And this motor though, this is going to be her first full rebuild, and we'll call it a rebuild because it's a razor blade rebuild, but I'm pretty confident she's going to do good on it. And we are actually going to be following her along on this rebuild, and we're going to do it like it's ready to accept boost. We're not boosting it yet. So we'll see where it goes. But anyway, we'll probably end up putting this in another vehicle one day. But for now, it's going to go in the truck because I need a motor. I'm sure that you have more questions as well as I do. So I really look forward to the comments on this video and any help that we can help anyone else that's going to be doing these low budget rebuilds on these LSs would be great. So if you don't mind, please share this video and like and subscribe.